Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we're doing my updated hair care routine. So if you've been with me for a while, you know that my hair used to be almost down to my waist. It was long, it was healthy, it was just super shiny. If you look at any of my older videos, like when I first started, my hair was just super healthy and strong. And then I decided to dye it. I believe it was 3 years ago, I decided to do a balayage, or I attempted to. So I went to a salon, I got over processed. It was a complete fail. I mean, my hair was so processed. So the first time I went to a salon, it was like really reputable. I paid a lot of money. I walked out with over processed brown hair. So I had bleach on and I was in rollers, like under the dryer. I had always dyed my hair black myself, so I never really did salon dyeing. When I was a lot younger, when I was a teenager, I dyed my own balayage kind of highlight situation, kind of like an ombre. I did my own at home blonde and it was fine. Like, my hair wasn't processed. But fast forward to like 3 years ago, I don't really know what I was doing. I was going through something, I don't know, and I just was like, I need to change my hair. So that was a complete fail. I ended up going to someone else and she fixed it, but it was just too chunky. It looked like highlights and my hair was really short. So I cut my hair. Well, I didn't cut it. The lady cut my hair to my shoulders because it was so damaged. It was falling off. It was just so uneven. So she ended up having to cut it really short, actually above my shoulders. My hair growing up was really dark. It was like a dark brown, but with like red undertones. So I felt super vulnerable and insecure when I had short and blonde highlighted hair. It just wasn't me. So for a while I kept it like that. And now fast forward 3 years later, I have my almost normal hair back. So strong. It's growing so fast. And you guys are asking me like, what voodoo are you using? Because my hair was so fried and so dry and so just damaged that you guys are like, how is it growing if it's so damaged? So today I'm going to be sharing with you all of the products that I have been using and I still use to keep my hair healthy and also to grow it out. Disclaimer, if you're new to my channel and you don't know, I'm a product junkie. So in any video that I ever post, I have a lot of products because that's actually what I do. I do use a lot of products, but the main products that I'm going to talk to you about today are the ones that helped me grow my hair out. My hair used to grow really fast on its own, like without any products. I have like that strong Peruvian gene. My dad's hair grows really fast. My brother's hair grows really fast. So naturally my hair would always grow fast, but once I started over processing it and bleaching it, it just stopped growing completely. Like, it was just at my shoulders for a really long time, and to get it to get past that took forever, or what felt like forever, until I was introduced to a line. This video is not sponsored, but I was introduced to a line that I am now obsessed with. I talk about it a lot, and it is the Vida Hair Growth. I was doing a seminar in Uptown New York, and I was introduced to this line by the owner and her daughter, and I had been going to the owner's daughter's nail salon for a really long time, and I didn't even know that her mom created such an amazing line. So it's not something that's being sold in many stores. You can get it at one location. They do deliver. I would say a little under 3 years I was introduced to this line, and I just never looked back. So my hair again was bleached, it was fried, it was damaged, and I really wanted to get it back to healthy, strong, and I decided to go back to black. So after dyeing my hair blonde, I was using Vida, but I just didn't feel comfortable with the blonde, so I decided to dye it black. But also I felt like I needed to go back to what my natural hair color is, or something close to it, which is black. That's something that kind of helped speed the process, because bleached hair or dyed hair is really hard to maintain. So my tip number one is to go back to your natural hair color. And I know for some people that's like a big no-no, but if you want it to be healthy, it's just something that would make the process easier. Of course, you can have healthy dyed hair. I'm not saying you can't, but it's just easier if you go back to your normal hair and you just go to one color. If you have a lot of highlights and balayage and ombres and just a lot of things going on, it's harder to upkeep, and you have to upkeep it. You have to constantly be dyeing it, where if you go to your natural color, you don't have to dye it. So that's like the plus. For a while, I was dyeing my hair black and the bleach was coming through because it was just so strong. But now that I don't have that issue anymore, it just kind of stays this color. I haven't actually dyed my hair in, I think, over 3 months. I do have some new growth coming in, so I do plan on dyeing my hair. So maybe I'll film that. But I use the Clairol Nice and Easy in blue black. I'll insert a picture right here. And that's the hair dye that I've always used. I love it. I swear by it. It doesn't rinse out. Like, it just stays in my hair. I kept these empty bottles just to show you. This one still has a little bit in it, but I've gone through quite a few of these. So I've been using this non-stop. I use a shampoo and the conditioner, consistently. I have a couple of other products from them that I'm going to talk to you about, but this is what basically has helped my hair grow so fast. I really like that the bottles tell you exactly what's in it. So for example, in this shampoo bottle, it says the ingredients are molasses, watercress, yaca, and it's literally just 5 ingredients, and it just says to apply it like normal and just to leave it on for 5 minutes. And then like this conditioner says it has calendula, oat straw, coconut, and molasses. And when you smell this product, it's very natural. So it is available in New York. You can actually order it and pay through PayPal and then have them deliver it to you. I believe they're working on a website, so I'm praying and hoping that that is true. But I travel an hour into Upper Manhattan just to get this. So my hair has gotten so thick. My hair used to fall out in chunks. Even when I went back to black after the blonde, my hair would just fall out and it was just so thin and it looked lifeless. It was not shiny even though it was black. It didn't look super healthy. Now I have gotten a couple of keratin treatments done. In total, I've gotten 3 keratin treatments. The last one that I did was a year ago. I got it done at a random Dominican hair salon, and it just basically helped me not put so much heat damage. I know keratin treatments are not good for you. There's chemicals, and a lot of people are against them. But for me personally, I was just trying to not heat style my hair as often because I'm a huge flat iron kind of person. So whenever I wash my hair, either air dry or blow dry it, I absolutely feel like I need to straighten it because my natural hair is straight with frizz. So it does get really frizzy because that's just like my natural hair. That last keratin that I did was pretty strong, but now when I wash my hair, it's getting a little frizzy. If you're someone that's constantly washing their hair, whether it's because of the gym or just you just are always washing it and you're tired of putting so much heat damage on your hair, then look into the keratin. I know, again, it's touchy subject. A lot of people are really against it, but I think it actually helped me because I didn't have to heat style it so much. So yes, you're processing your hair, you're putting chemicals, but you're actually defrizzing your hair so you don't have to style it. So I would wash and just go. So now, fast forward a year later, I wash and I do have to style my hair again because the keratin's washing off or like wearing off. But the shampoo and conditioner that I've been using is the Vita. This is what's helping my hair grow. It's all natural. This is for everyone. Thin, coarse, curly, straight, oily, dry. It's for everyone. If you want really strong hair, this is for you. So I know a lot of people who suffer from alopecia use this. People who are going through chemotherapy use it. People use it on their eyebrows. Men use it on their beards. Like, this is just amazing. And I love that it's all natural. The owner of this brand is so kind and so sweet. If you want to talk about like the ingredients or how she does everything or why she decided to create this line, you can just message her. She's so easy to talk to and she'll definitely share her story with you if you want, or if you want to just tell her about your condition or, you know, what your hair condition is, you can send her pictures. She's really sweet, very personable, and she has that like motherly instinct, and she just really cares about her customers a lot. I love supporting local businesses, so I'm so happy that I found this line, and I literally just went uptown last week to pick up my re-up, and you don't know how happy I am to have my re-up. I actually bring this to the salon with me, so I did get my hair done yesterday. I didn't do this to my hair. I suck at like curling or like flipping my ends, but I bring this with me to the salon, and every time I use it or every time they use it, they're like, oh, that smells so good. It smells so natural. My main hair salon was shocked to see how fast my hair was growing. Everyone in the salon was like, you need to tell me the secret. What are you putting in your hair? So I have to give it up to the Vita. The main thing was going back to my natural hair color and then using the Vita hair growth. So I've been using the shampoo and conditioner. So a lot of you guys ask me how often I use it. So depending on how often I'm washing my hair that week, let's just say in 7 days, I'm gonna be doing my hair 3 times, once at the salon and twice at home. I'll use the Vita twice out of those 3 times or once out of those 3 times. So I kind of like to shock my hair and kind of switch it up. So I'll use the shampoo and the conditioner at the salon. They'll wash my hair like normal. I'll get it styled, and then let's say 3 days later I'm washing my hair at home, I'll use something else. Depending, sometimes I'll use the Vita again. I just kind of like to switch it up. I don't like to keep the same products. It's different than with skincare. With hair care, I totally feel comfortable shocking my hair and switching things up. So I'll wash my hair with something else. The Vita smells very natural, which I do like, and it just smells like coconuts and just like natural plants. But sometimes I want a little bit more of like a perfume scent, so I'll use something else. So for example, I'll use the Joico K-Pack Color Therapy Shampoo and Conditioner. I got this at TJ Maxx for really cheap. It smells so good. This is to preserve color, so I feel like when I use this, my color, my black just looks really shiny and it stands out a little bit more. So I really like this because it smells good and it makes my hair shiny. Another shampoo and conditioner that I'll use is this one from IGK. This is the 30,000 feet volume shampoo and conditioner. Also smells amazing. This one's really good for volume. If I'm not using these, I'll use the R & Co. Dallas shampoo and conditioner. I literally just switch it up. I have Redken in my shower. My shower is literally filled with so many options because I just switch it up. But what has remained consistent over the years is the Vita. So this is really what I owe everything to. I feel like this is like my ride or die. Whenever I use the Vita, my hair looks, feels shinier, stronger, fuller. It feels great. I will say it does leave my roots a little bit oily, but that's because it's so natural. There's a lot of plants and herbs. So by day three, my hair is very oily with the Vita, but I don't mind it because I feel like an oily scalp is a healthy growing scalp. So I don't let it get super greasy, but that's another thing. I don't like to wash my hair too often. So most I'll wash my hair in a week is 3 times. I try to go for 2. That has also helped my hair grow a lot tremendously, is not washing it as often. I limit it to 2 to 3 times a week. That's just what's gonna help my hair look better in the long run. So you kind of just have to sacrifice. You just have to kind of learn to love a ponytail or a good bun. So I do switch my shampoo and conditioner. So that's what I've been doing this whole time, is switching out but always using the Vita at least once a week. That's like a constant. It has to be that way for me to feel good and for my hair to feel good. The Vita, and then switching off. I've used Way, I've used Redken, I've used so many, Biolage, I've used so many. So that's what I do for shampoo and conditioner in the shower. Another huge tip that I have for healthy long hair to grow your hair out is to use a deep conditioner. I don't know what it is about this deep conditioner. I've been using it for years. Like, my original long, healthy, thick hair was all because of this. So this is the Macadamia Deep Repair Mask. This is for dry, damaged hair. I mainly put this on my ends, but I do put a little bit on my scalp. But this also just helps my hair grow. I know deep conditioners aren't really formulated to make your hair grow. They're meant to make your hair healthy, but I think healthy hair grows faster. So as long as it's nice and moisturized and not weighed down, I have been using this for so long. They don't sell it everywhere like they used to before. You have to make sure you get the right one. Sometimes they sell fake ones online, but I swear by this deep conditioner mask. Unless I'm getting my hair done at the salon, if I'm washing my hair at home, I always do a deep conditioner mask. Now, I only wash my hair about twice a week, so if it's once at the salon and once at home in 1 week, I'm only doing this once a week. So I know it sounds like a lot, but I don't wash my hair that often. Sometimes I'll use the Vita shampoo and then this. Sometimes I'll even do the Vita shampoo, conditioner, and this. Just really depends. I feel like you have to listen to your hair, feel it, see what it needs. If I've applied a lot of heat throughout the week, if I've straightened it twice or something, I'll definitely not skip the deep conditioner mask. This one smells really good and it does the job so well. This is my favorite hands down deep conditioner mask that I've ever used. This is my number one pick. I also really love this silicone mix bamboo. So this is another deep conditioner mask. So this is a Dominican hair product. They have it at like Ricky's and beauty supply stores. This has bamboo extract. I do have the shampoo for this as well, but the conditioner is so good. It makes your hair so soft, so manageable, silky, shiny. It's awesome. It smells so good to me. Yeah, I use this one, but mainly the macadamia one. I'll use this one maybe like once every other week. It doesn't weigh my hair down and it really just leaves my hair so shiny. I love using deep conditioners. And another one that I've been using as of recently is this IGK Prenup Instant Spray Hair Mask. So this is something totally new, innovative. It's a spray-on hair mask. So while I'm in the shower, I'll shampoo and then I'll just condition my hair with this spray, and I don't put this on my scalp. What I love about this is that it doesn't take long for it to work. You only need to leave it on for a minute, which is perfect because I'm so impatient with my deep conditioners. I hate waiting like 5-10 minutes. I don't know how people leave it on for 30 minutes in the shower. It's like impossible for me, but this one works so fast. It smells amazing and instantly your hair will be detangled. Now that my hair is getting longer, it's more prone to tangles. So this just works so well. So going back to switching it up, I don't use all of this at once. I'll use one or the other just depending on my mood, depending on what I'm feeling like. So this one is great for people who are in a rush, who don't like to wait. This is amazing. You get this at Sephora and the brand is IGK and their packaging is really nice. So that's what I do in the shower. I do the shampoo, the conditioner, conditioner, a deep conditioner mask. If I'm doing a mask outside of the shower, I'll do the Vita Hair Growth Mask. This one I don't really use that often. I should, because I've heard like this works amazing. I've only used it like 5 times. I don't know, is there something about doing conditioner outside the shower that kind of like bothers me, but I will do it occasionally. This one you're supposed to apply to dry hair, and then you shampoo and condition like regular in the shower. This one has quinoa, secret plants, horsetail root, cinnamon. This is like the miracle product for people. Although for me, the miracle product is a shampoo, because that's what's constantly touching my scalp and is giving that new growth. But another product that I swear by now is a newer one from them, and this is the Vita Hair Growth Serum Styling Mist. At first, I didn't really think I was gonna like it. I'm like, oh, it's a styling mist. It might leave my hair a little greasy, but it doesn't. So immediately after the shower, when my hair is still wet, I'll towel dry it, and then I'll spray a generous amount of this just pretty much all around my scalp. I just got a new one, so that's how you know it's real, because I'm still using this one and I already have another one. This says it has aloe vera, basil, Moroccan seeds, horsetail, so a bunch of really natural ingredients. I don't feel like this alters my hair, doesn't make it sticky. If anything, it brings out the natural wave in my hair. So if you have curly hair, I think this product would be amazing for you. But I have like frizzy straight with a little bit of a wave, so I love this. I just shake it up and I just spray it all around my hair, and then if I'm in a rush, I'll just walk out and air dry my hair, or I'll just start to blow dry it myself. If I'm going to the salon, I don't bring that with me. I should actually, but I just haven't really thought of that. So whether I'm gonna be heat styling my hair or not, air drying it or blow drying it, I always do these two next products. So this one is the Phyto Lightweight Hydrating Oil for dry and fine hair. And so when I first saw it, I was like, how is that an oil? It's like a cream in a spray form, which I love. I personally hate using oils on my hair because they usually weigh it down. So when I found this, I fell in love. I've already gone through one full bottle of this. It sprays like a cream, so I don't know if you see that. This really just helps defrizz my hair, detangle my hair, and it just makes blow drying it so much easier. And if I'm not gonna be heat styling my hair, I'll still use it because it defrizzes it. So it'll help kind of style it, and I can kind of mold my hair, or depending on how I brush it, it'll really help with just the overall look of my hair. And then I'll also spray this Kenra Blow Dry Spray. So this is a dermal protectant. This defrizzes my hair so much. I've gone through so many of these. I'll even spray this if I'm not using heat, which is really weird, but I love how it smells. I'm just like so used to using it that I just won't not use it. So if I'm doing my own hair, I always spray this. Again, not on the scalp, on the body of my hair. It helps defrizz. It helps cut down the blow drying time dramatically. So if you're looking for a product to help you blow dry your hair, this one is phenomenal. It's so good for any hair type. If you're applying heat, make sure you're applying heat protectant. Most heat protectants are just too oily. So what I love about this one is that it's not. It's very lightweight. It smells so good. It doesn't feel like you're using a heat protectant and spray. It feels like you're using something to just make your hair smell good and look good. So love this, and you can get this at Ulta. This is the Kenra Blow Dry Spray. So I've been using this for years and years. I've never stopped. It's so good. So I switch between two blow dryers. I either use this T3 Feather, I think it's called the Feather Light or the Feather Weight blow dryer with the nozzle, or I'll use this one, the Turbo. I got this one, I think, on Amazon. Twin Turbo 3200. I got this one because the girls at the salon use this, and I just like how strong this one is. This one will burn your hair if you leave it like on your scalp. It gets very hot, but it does the job really quickly. And this one I'll use if I'm not really trying to damage my hair. So I'll use this one if I'm in a rush. I'll use this one if I'm really just taking my time. But I love both. They get the job done. I'm not a really great blow dryer, to be honest. If I'm gonna be straightening my hair, I don't like to blow dry and straighten. But if I'm in a rush, I will. But I try to air dry and then straighten. But I never just blow dry and just let it be, because it's still a little frizzy, and I like to kind of curve my ends a little. So I'll always use a flat iron. I feel like I've tried every flat iron, straightening iron in the whole entire world. I've tried Babyliss, I've tried the T3, I've tried a lot. And my favorite one by far has been this one. This is the Bioionic 10x Flat Iron. I tried the other one from Bioionic, but I like this one more. So I love the curved plates. It is very expensive, but this one actually vibrates. It has an option to vibrate on or off. This just leaves my hair so silky and so soft so fast. You don't need to apply so much pressure, and one swipe, your hair is straight and silky, so you don't have to put so much heat on your hair. Sometimes you'll flat iron your hair with something and then the ends just don't look good. With this, since it's like skinny and curved, you can easily grab the hair and kind of just curve the ends. So it's really good if you want to curl your hair with a flat iron, but if you just want to straighten it, this one just leaves your hair so silky and so soft, and I don't feel like I'm burning my hair. It goes all the way up to 450. Sometimes I'll do 400, 300, 350. It just depends, again, on how much time I have, but this has been my favorite flat iron. I love the plates. They're very smooth. They don't pull my hair. It was such a great investment. I think I've been using this for about 8 months, or maybe like less than a year for sure, but it's definitely been my favorite, and nothing has ever happened to it. Never fails me. It turns on. It'll let you know when it's ready to use, and it's just been very easy. So really happy about this. This is like a definite must for me because I do flat iron my hair quite a lot. If I'm styling my own hair, I'll use a flat iron. So this was worth the investment. This has been great for me, and it's the BioIonic 10 times flat iron. You can get this at Sephora, and it was definitely worth the investment for me. For oils, I love this It's a 10 Miracle Oil Plus Keratin. If I'm air drying my hair, I'll use the original It's a 10 treatment. I just like how it leaves my hair a little bit wavy, and it just kind of texturizes my hair a little but leaves it very soft. But if I'm straightening it, I'll use a little bit of this oil either before or after, mainly when it's wet, just like on the ends, just to kind of help smooth everything out. And I love using products with keratin, so try the It's a 10 line if you haven't. The two standout products from this line are the Miracle Oil and the original It's a 10 treatment. I have their blow dry spray, I have their creams, I have so many of their products. All of the It's a 10 products smell so good. I'll use about half a pump for this oil. If my hair is styled like this, I'll kind of just apply a little bit to the ends, and it just leaves it looking really fresh and shiny. And I love shiny hair, but I don't like my hair to look greasy, so I love that this one is a lightweight oil that packs a lot of shine, and it has keratin, so it's helping your hair get stronger and bond that keratin. So I love products with keratin, so I'll use that. Another product that I've recently put into my routine is this R & Co High Dive Moisture and Shine Cream. This is probably the best smelling hair product that I own, and I'll use this on my wet hair before styling it or before air drying it. This is a moisturizing shine cream. I really love that it smells good, first of all, but second of all, I love that it moisturizes my ends, but it's very light weight. So if I'm not using the Phyto, I'll use this one. This is perfect for anyone with bleached hair, with overprocessed hair. It really conditions. It's like using a conditioner outside the shower. So if you get out of the shower and your hair is still dry and dull, like the ends especially, definitely get this. Your hair is gonna definitely thank you. It's kind of like a leave-in conditioner, but I don't really like leave-in conditioners, but I really, really like this. It helps tone down frizz. It helps you blow dry or style your hair or just air dry it. It's so good, and it smells so yummy. So I love using that. I recently started incorporating that into my routine. So the first day that I do my hair, I'll skip this step, but like on the second day, or depending if I'm going to an event or dinner or something, I'll use a shine spray. So both of these are from Alterna, from the Bamboo line. This is the Kendi Oil Dry Oil Mist, and this is the Luminous Shine Mist. I also have their purple one. I just left it in my cupboard, but I love Alterna shine sprays. They're the best shine sprays that I've ever tried, because they don't leave your hair greasy, they don't weigh your hair down, but they give you so much shine. I'll mainly do the body of my hair. Again, nothing really goes on my scalp because my scalp naturally has its oils, especially with the Vita. So I'll try to just spray the body of my hair once, twice from afar. When your hair is not shiny and it looks dull, it just doesn't look healthy. It doesn't look bouncy and youthful. So shiny hair for me is a must. So with black hair, I know it has like that natural shine, but I still like to add my own extra little oomph, a little extra shine. So I'll use these, and the products that I use, almost all of them help with shine, but sometimes you just need a little extra gloss. So I'll use those. Because I'm applying so many products on the first day, I'll kind of skip the shine, unless again I'm going out or something, but usually I'll use a shine mist on the second day. And then if I have little flyaways or little frizzies at the top, hands down this is the best frizz controller or flyaway tamer. This is one of my favorite products that I've ever been put onto because it works so well. So it's a touch-up cream. It'll seal in any like flyaways, any frizzies that you have. It literally comes out like a cream, and it smells awesome. It smells so good. I don't like using products that don't have an amazing scent. I'll just rub it between my palms. I'll just apply this right on top where I have any frizzies. I'll have those little annoying strands popping out like alfalfa. Like I'll just have like two at the top, like little end antennas. So this just instantly tames them. I'll use it like on the actual body of my hair. This is an awesome product to just touch up with. I literally will bring this with me whenever I go out, like in my purse. I'll just throw this in because it comes so in handy, and it gives you a little bit of a shine. You can use this anytime, anywhere. Like it's just It's bomb. This is definitely a must have for me. I love it. When my hair is in a ponytail, I use it, but mainly for when I have those little antennas, those little frizzies kind of popping out. For dry shampoos, I feel like I've tried so many. I have yet to find like my ultimate favorite. This one comes really close. This is the Batiste dry shampoo for dark and deep brown with a hint of color. Not too crazy again about the scent on this one, which is why I feel like I don't use this as often as I should. I feel like if they just made this with like a nice floral scent. I know they have other ones with floral scents, but if they had the dark and deep brown with either no scent or a nicer scent, I feel like I would like love it. If you're looking for a dry shampoo for the day of, this one's great. If I use any dry shampoo the next day, my hair is not so happy with me. It looks very dirty and not so good. But for the day of, this one works well and it's really inexpensive, so I like that. Another oil that I've used up a lot that I do really, really like is this one from Way, and this is just their Way hair oil. Smells really good, and I like that this one is more lightweight than most. I don't know if you can see it, but it's very fluid, which I love. I don't love really thick, goopy, strong oils. I like them to be a little bit more watery, if that makes sense, because my hair is thin, long, and it can easily get weighed down. I love this one. I mainly use this on my wet hair, so before styling. I'll use a little bit if I'm not afraid of it getting a little oily, because sometimes I get a little carried away with oil and shine and all these products. So I'll use the tiniest bit if I'm going to use this on dry hair, and I'll mainly use this on my ends. But I feel like now that my hair is black and back to shiny and healthy, I don't really need to use this as much on dry hair, but I will use it on my wet hair to help me just style everything. My main thing is just defrizzing, because I do get frizzy, so I like to put all the products when my hair is wet, really let it soak in so that when it's drying, I have to do less heat. So that means less damage. So that's like the main goal, is to get my hair to dry, air dry, as best as it can. Another thing that I sometimes do is apply some castor oil. This is cold pressed castor oil organic. My bottle's a little broken. I got this on Amazon, but I'll take a little bit of this on the dropper and I'll apply it to the back of my scalp. So I don't really like to apply this on the scalp. This is the type of oil that I just described before. Thick, goopy, not so great for my hair type, but I'll use just a tiny, tiny bit on the back of my head, especially if I'm gonna put my hair up in a ponytail or in a bun or in a hat. I'll then apply a nice amount of this, and this really helps your hair grow. I mainly bought this to use on my eyebrows and my eyelashes, and it works so great for that. So I'm like, why didn't I use this on my scalp? I know a lot of people do that, but I'm like, why am I not doing that? I've recently started doing that. I'll do this about once every other week. I honestly forget to do it. If I remembered more often, I think my hair would grow even faster, because this stuff is good. I really want to get Jamaican castor oil, but this one is just castor oil. But that's another little tip that I have, is to use castor oil for hair growth. Any hair that you want to grow, castor oil. These two Vita hair growth products, this one I have used a lot, this one not so much. This is the Vita hair growth leave-in tonic. This says it has ginseng, honey, bamboo, secret plants. So I went through a whole bottle of this. I have a little bit left. I do have to finish it up. I'll shake this up and use this on my scalp. So I was using this before I discovered the hairstyling mist, but this also helps your hair grow. Anything from their line is going to help your hair grow. So you can honestly trust in whatever they're carrying at the moment, because they do switch it up. And then this one is the leave-in potion. This says it has horsetail roots, ragoon roots, and secret plants. And you apply this to your scalp 3 times a week. I like the applicator on this one. Boom, you just apply it. I like using these products when my hair is wet. I just feel like it soaks in better. So I'll use things like this when my hair is damp. I get creative. Sometimes I'll throw that in, sometimes I won't. But the main thing is the Vita shampoo and the conditioner and the styling mist. Those are like my main products. To be honest, I don't really hairspray my hair that often anymore. But if I am gonna hairspray my hair, I'll either use the Kenra Volume, or this one is like my all-time favorite forever. This is the L'Oreal Elnit Satin. This one is the unscented in the extra strong hold. I like the volumizing one. I just love L'Oreal Elnit. I know a lot of people don't like the scent, so you can get the unscented. And this is just bomb. It literally holds your hair so well. It doesn't leave it super hard. If I have my hair flipped and curled, I'll just spray the ends and they'll kind of just stay like that. I mainly like to spray my bangs to kind of keep it in place, or to give me a little bit more like volume. But if I have my hair straight, I really don't use hairspray. I try to minimize the amount of hairspray that I use and that I'm putting out into the world. But this one is so good, so readily available, L'Oreal. It's, I think, $20 at the drugstore, but it's so worth it. You get so much, and I love that it's a fine, ultra fine mist. Says the finest hairspray. So yes, I agree with that. It's so fine. It's like perfect. You really just get a nice even coat, not like a hard spray that leaves your hair crunchy and nasty. This one you can brush out, which I like. No white flakes. I really enjoy this. And again, I don't use that often, but when I do need one, I'll use that one. And the last product is this Briogeo Scalp Revival Charcoal and Coconut Oil Micro Exfoliating Shampoo. If my scalp is getting dry, or if I have dandruff, or it's just getting too oily and it's just like not balanced, I'll use this as a treatment. I love using clarifying treatments because I use so many products which can cause dandruff or an oily scalp. So I love clarifying treatments. I love exfoliating treatments for my scalp. I love clarifying shampoos. So I'll use that once a week or once every other week. The key is just to like listen to your body and to listen to your hair. And I know that sounds kind of silly, but look at it, examine it, know your hair, like know your body, know what it's telling you. If it's dry or if it's oily, pay attention. If you need to write it down, like a journal, like, okay, my hair was doing really good today. What did I use? Like write things down and like really observe. I know it sounds like a lot of products, and that's because it is, but that's just what has been working for me. I don't use everything at once. I don't like to overwhelm my hair either, but I do like to get my hair done once a week just because then I know that it's gonna last me a really long time, and it just looks better in my opinion for video. Like I like how they flip my ends and how they curl my hair. It just doesn't look so blah plain. I only really know how to like straighten my hair. I don't really know how to curl it to how I like it, like this. If you see me in person, most of the time I'm rocking a very oily ponytail because that's really what has helped my hair grow, is just letting it be. Let time kind of pass. I have not gotten a trim in a really long time. I used to trim my hair about every 3 to 4 months. I have not gotten a trim. I don't even remember the last time I got a trim. I just make sure to keep my ends really protected with a lot of oils and a lot of deep conditioners to avoid trimming it, because every time I trim it, it just gets shorter. And I know it's good and healthy to trim your hair. I'm actually due for one, so I'll probably trim it in about 2 weeks. Some people get scissor happy and then just trim a little bit too much, so it's really hard for me to trust anyone with my hair now that it's growing. Get a trim if you absolutely need one. If you take care of your hair, I don't really feel like you need to be getting a trim that often. And as far as the Vita hair growth, if you guys have any other questions, let me know, or you can actually ask the owner herself. I'll leave her Instagram down below. The owner of Vita will usually have like a sale going on or a bundle deal on her Instagram, so check that out for like any new offers or deals. Usually the set is from $100 to $130. The bottles do last you a really long time. Again, depending on how much you're using, how often you're washing your hair, and if you're using other products, I would say these last you about 2 to 4 to 6 months. It really depends on how much you're using. The main product that goes for me is the shampoo, because that's what I use so often, and I'll do like a deep conditioner. So it really just depends. I kind of just wing it. I don't have like a set routine, but I like to just listen to my hair and see what it's lacking, what it's needing. So that's what has been working for me. I know you guys have been noticing my growth. I haven't worn extensions in a really long time. Right now my hair is curled, so it's a little bit shorter. That's all me, girl. My longest layer goes right underneath like my nipple area. I know TMI, but that's where my growth is at right now. I don't really take pictures or like record it, but I just kind of let it be and forget. For 2 years, it felt like my hair wasn't growing, but then one day I just woke up and I was like, wait, it did grow. It's back. Like my hair is back. And I got so happy, and I've just been so much happier now because I feel like the regular old me. I love to see other people rock short hair, no hair, colored hair, but me personally, long black, regular, plain Jane hair is just what frames my face the best. It just goes with my face, I feel like, the best. So I would love to do like red or blonde again or short hair, but for now, I'm just letting it grow, and I just want it to get longer and healthier and stronger. If you want to see these products in action, let me know. Obviously not everything, but if you want to see like a day in the life of Rose's hair, like washing it and styling it, leave a comment down below and thumbs up this video to let me know that you want that. Let me know if you have any questions on any of these products or any other thing that I might have left out. Hope you guys found this video helpful. I know it was a long one. I know it's a lot of products, but thank you to everyone who has supported me through my hair journey. You guys would always just root for me, even if you saw just a little bit of growth. So that concludes this video. I hope you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye, guys.